Morning children, today I am going to teach you computer of standard 2 and the first chapter is computer and electronic device. Now computer is an electronic device. It is used almost everywhere. A computer helps us to do many things. We can, as you know children, computer helps us in doing many things. In standard 1 also you have learned the uses of computer. Now, in computer, we can draw pictures, we can type letters, we can play games, we can solve sums, we can watch movies and cartoons, listen to music. So, there are so many works we can do in a computer. Now, next we will learn about computer versus man, comparison of computer with man. So, a computer works very fast and can do many jobs at the same time, whereas man needs more time to do any work as compared to a computer. So children, we know that computer is very fast, no? It can do work faster than man. Man is little slow in doing work. Next is, computer has a good memory. It never forgets anything that is stored in it, and man may forget. We human beings, we forget. Sometimes you too forget what you learn. But a computer will never forget. It has a very good memory. Not like us. Now, computer does not make any mistake. A man can make mistakes. So here we see that computer does not make any mistake. But a man can make mistake. We all make mistake. No, you make mistake, I make mistake. But computers, you will see, generally they don't make any mistakes. No errors. Now, a computer cannot take its own decision. A man can take its own decisions. See, man will have to order the computer what to do. Then only the computer will work. But computer cannot work on its own. It needs orders or cannot take its own decision. It needs a man's order to work. Okay. Now, a computer works on man's order. Okay, it is same thing like here. A man does not need any order to work. So computer, it cannot work on its own. It needs orders to work. But a man does not need any order to work. It can work on its own. Okay, it uses its brain. But computer cannot use its brain to work on its their own. A computer does not have any feeling. For example, if you hit a monitor, it does not react. A man has feelings. For example, if you get hurt, you feel it. See, when anybody hits you or you get hurt, you start crying. But does a computer do? If you hit a computer or if a computer gets hurt, it does not, because it has no feeling. It is an object. It does not have any feeling, no human feeling. Because working of a computer. Now, a computer cannot work on its own. We need to enter letters, numbers, pictures and instructions into the computer to make it work. These are called data. Now, what is data, children? These letters, numbers, pictures and instruction, what we put into the computer is known as data. Okay, mark this. Different parts of a computer do different tasks. A computer works in three basic steps. Now, what are the three basic steps which computer works? It is input, process and output. Now, how do we understand this? Input, process and output. Input is when, say suppose you take a blunt pencil. This blunt pencil is your input. Now, you have to sharpen it, no? So, when you sharpen the pencil, it is doing the work. The doing work is known as process. Now, after you sharpen the pencil, you have a sharp pencil, pointed one. This is your output. Now, same way, we look here, another example. You take dirty clothes. Your dirty clothes is your input. Okay, dirty clothes. Now, when you put it in the washing machine to wash it, it is washing. Washing means this is doing some work. Doing work means it is process, in process. This washing is known as process. And when you get, after that, you get clean clothes, that clean clothes is your output. Okay? Now, same way, take another example of our body. Now, when your teacher, now as you are listening, You listen, no, in the class, when a teacher asks you any question, you use what to listen? How do you hear? How do you hear? You use your ears and you see with your eyes. So these two things are your input units. You are listening with your ears, you are listening, and with your eyes, you are listening to, you are seeing your teacher. And when you want to say the answer, you are thinking how to say the answer, and so your brain is working with it, with your answer, what answer you will give. So that working of the brain is known as processing unit. The brain is processing your answers. And when you give the answers, how do you give your answers? With your mouth. So your mouth is working like an output unit. Now, same way, children, here also in this page we see input, process and output. Just now I have explained to you with examples. Now, let's again read here what is input, what is called input. The data and instruction that we enter into a computer are called input. We input data using a keyboard and a mouse. How do you put in data? Data means you type letters, numbers, pictures and instructions. So how do you put? You put it, you use mouse and keyboard. Okay. Now process. What is process? Working on the data is called process. Now whichever data you have entered into the computer works on that data. Now working on the data is known as process. How does the process takes place in the computer system? The CPU works on the data and does all the thinking and calculation. As you have learnt in standard 1, that CPU is the brain of the computer. So all the working is done by the CPU. Okay. Now let's move on to output. What is output? Output means the final result. Now after the input, after you put in the input and the process is done, you get the result, final result, and which is called output. When the CPU finishes processing the data, the output is displayed on the monitor. Monitor and printer are the most common output device. Now how do you get the output? Where do you see the output? You see either on the monitor or as a printout form, you see it on the printer. So these two are examples of the output data. Now let's see the advantages of computer. What are the advantages of computer? Teaching. In teaching, it helps the teacher to get information on any topic on the internet as well as present it nicely. So in teaching also, the computer helps the teacher to get all the information on any topic. Now, when we talk about speed, as we have learnt before, a computer works very fast without getting tired. Man gets tired, but computer does not get tired. So this is the advantage of computer. Then entertainment. It is a good source of entertainment for the children. You know, children, now also in quarantine period, you are busy with the mobile, busy with the computer. So the computer is also keeping you little engaged and busy. But along with this, you should study also. Now, next come to calculation. A computer can perform complex calculations without making any mistake. As we have learned earlier, computer makes no mistake. It does not make any mistake like human being. Now, electronic presentation. Text and pictures in a computer can be presented in a beautiful way. Moreover, these can be edited whenever needed. So when we writing text or pictures, we can do it in a computer and it looks very beautiful. Okay. Now, storage capacity. Computer stores a large amount of information. As we store information in our brain, so computer also stores a large amount of information. Where does it store, children? It stores in its CPU. The storage place is CPU. Multitasking. It can do many tasks at the same time. For example, you can listen to music while typing a letter on a computer. Now, computer at a time, it can do many work. Multitasking means many work at the same time. You can you can type letter as well as you can listen to the music in the computer. Automation. A computer can work in an automatic way. This makes a work less prone to errors. Now, computer works automatically, so it makes less errors, less mistakes. It makes not like human beings. It makes less mistakes. Now, disadvantages of computer. As we have advantages of computer, we also have the negative part of computer, that is disadvantages. Now, first one is decisions. A computer works on human orders as it cannot take its own decisions. As I have explained to you earlier, children, remember that computer needs order to work. It cannot work on its own. We come to health. If a child works on a computer for a long time, the rays emitted by the monitor affects the eyesight, and wrong sitting posture is harmful for physical growth. Then we come to impact on environment. Computer depends on electricity. To generate electricity, a lot of fuel is burnt in power plants that causes pollution. Now, computer works with electricity. Now, how is this electricity generated? It is generated with a lot of fuel. So, when in the power plant means factories. Now, in the power plant to generate electricity, they use fuel and that causes air pollution. Now, we come to cybercrime. Cybercrime use of internet may also increase the number of crimes like stealing of data, banking frauds, etc. Now, here, children, cybercrime means cybercrime is related to computer. This crime is done by hacking the computer and stealing your personal information. Costly. It is also a costly device. Costly means, children, this is very expensive device. Computer is an expensive device. So, this is the advantage of a computer. Now, children, I have explained to you this chapter. There are some exercises. Please follow the instruction given to complete the homework. Thank you.